In this video, I'm going to show you 5 clever ways that you can cover jump cuts inside Premiere Pro. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
Okay, so to get started, what I'm gonna show you first is what I have in my timeline and how to work around it. So as we can see here inside Premiere Pro, I have this clip in my timeline and on this side of the cut I'm speaking. And then if we go to the cut point, you'll notice that if we go back and forth between the frames, it's a jump cut. So when we play this back, you'll notice that it stutters a little bit in between the cut. So I'm gonna show you how to cover that in 5 different ways. The first way is the obvious way. You can use what's called B-roll. And this essentially is a second video clip that is over your original A-roll clip that kind of covers the cut. So for example here, I usually speak about video editing. So say if I wanted to use B-roll of video editing, I can go find some clips of video editing and place it over my original clip here. And you'll notice that this covers the cut. So if we go into our effects controls, we can just scale this up. And if we play this back, you can see that we covered the jump cut by adding a B-roll over our footage. Now another tool you can use is called the Morph Cut. So say inside Premiere Pro, if you wanted to blend these two clips together, using the cross dissolve won't really work, but Morph Cut might be able to work. If we navigate to the effects panel, we can type in Morph Cut. If we click and drag this effect or transition in between these two clips, you can see that it's added. If we zoom in here, you'll see that it'll analyze the background and it'll try to morph the two clips together. Now I do have to say this sometimes works, it sometimes doesn't work. You'll notice in this clip specifically, my hands, since on this side of the cut, my hands are together and on this side of the cut, they're separated. Premiere Pro is trying to morph the two sides of the cut together and it kind of gets a little weird. But if you have a subject that doesn't move that much, this effect might work out for you. Another thing that you can try to do is click on the transition and change the duration to be shorter. For example, maybe 4 frames. That way it's only a little bit and the transition isn't too noticeable here. You'll notice that you still see the morphing happening, but it's not as noticeable when it's a shorter transition length. So if we play this back, this is another way to cover the cut. You can see it just kind of morphs the two clips together a little bit, making it a little less noticeable when it transitions. Another way that you can cover jump cuts is by cutting in or popping in on your video clip. For example here, I shoot in 4K by edit in a 1080 sequence. So by default, my video clip is set to 50% scale. What we can do is on the other side of the cut is click on this clip and scale it up. We can reset it. Say if we go back to 100, we can reposition this and we can zoom in basically as a close-up shot. So it kind of looks like we're going from a medium shot to more of a close-up shot. You don't have to go all the way. You can, you know, scale this down appropriately and rearrange your clip kind of looking like this. So it looks like you're going from a wide shot to a close-up shot here. Another way that you can cover a cut is by using split screens. To accomplish this, what we can do is click on our clip and just slide it over to the left. Now to create the split screen effect and to cut off, you know, this part of the video, what we can do is add a crop effect. So if we search for our crop effect inside the effects panel, we can click and drag this to our clip. And then inside effects controls, we can turn up the right value to cut it from the right. And we can put something else to the right of me. Now, one other note is we need to find the middle hash mark of where the center of our screen is. If we want to do a split screen where I'm on one half and the other graphic or B-roll is on the other half. So to do that, I'm going to toggle on my safe margins by clicking on this button. If you don't see this, you can always click on this plus button and click and drag them down to your menu here. But with this selected, you'll notice that we can see the center horizontally and vertically here, and we can more accurately align our video clip to be in the center. So for example, we can just slide this over inside effects controls, and now we have my clip on the left and we can display something on the right. For example, we can use the B-roll sequence that we talked about earlier. So we can just click and drag this over here. And same thing, we can scale this up and slide it over. And if we go into our effects controls, we can once again add a crop effect and this time change up the left value. That way we're cropping from the left. And you'll just have to tweak it until you are right in the middle there. So probably right around 38 is good. And just get it looking so it looks something like that. And that's how you can do an easy split screen effect inside Premiere Pro. So when it cuts, it kind of looks something like this. Another way that you can cover a jump cut is by using physical transitions. Now you can use the built-in transitions inside Premiere Pro, or you can use a stock website such as Envato Elements. So as you can see here, I'm inside Envato Elements and I downloaded these 20 clips of transition elements that I can use inside my project. So if we go back inside Premiere Pro, I can double click on one of them and click play inside the source monitor. And what we can do is add this part over the transition to kind of cover the jump cut. So what I recommend doing inside the source monitor is find the point in time where the transition happens. It's right here, it goes and dips to white. And what I'm going to do is add a marker by clicking M on my keyboard. Then what we can do is click and drag this into our timeline and then click and drag it over the point where the marker is. You can see we have that green marker right there. That way we know that's definitely where the transition happens. And one last thing we have to do here is change the blending mode so that this clip blends in with the clip underneath it. And to do that, just click on it, go into effects controls, and underneath opacity, change the blending mode to linear dodge add. And now when we click and play this back, you can see we add this fire burn transition to cover the jump cut. I hope these were helpful. If you want to learn more about Envato Elements, I did make a video reviewing them. I will link that video right up there. But that does it for this video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.